The COVID-19 pandemic, as well as the recent bushfires, have certainly hit our shire hard in more ways than one. This year's budget is all about the community and getting the community back on its feet. About 80% of our community will receive no increase in their rates notice, which will help to ease the burden in these trying times. To achieve this, we have slashed or cut the environment levy, the heritage levy, and the transport levy on general rates notices.
Because Noosa's had very strong cash surpluses ever since de-amalgamation because of financially sustainable principles that we operate on, we've been able to halve our inherited debt from de-amalgamation, which means that instead of money being going to loan repayments, we've been able to use it to keep rates low, spend money out in the community, which means that we face our first deficit budget in a very financially resilient position.
We are anticipating a budget deficit of about $1.8 million, but the good news is we have a COVID recovery plan and we will be back in surplus within 2 years.
This community's been hard hit by the pandemic, and supporting the community to deliver essential services to protect our lifestyle has been our commitment and has also underpinned all of our budget decisions.
I think the highlight for me is a significant spend on community facilities across the Shire, with renewals and upgrades to right from Perigean all the way through into the hinterland.
In fact, the hinterland is gaining a big share of the funding pie. There is over $3 million being allocated for projects in Karoi. Pomona receive over $400,000 for community projects and footpaths. And Kinkin and Karan share in over $3 million worth of projects.
The good thing about this budget is that with the state and federal government stimulus money, together with council's budget, we've been able to invest in hundreds of small projects throughout the Shire, and we'll be building community capacity and investing in jobs for local contractors, our local youth, at the same time building our community infrastructure.
Well, the highlight for this budget has to be empathy. It sits at the heart of this budget and reaches out to community and shows we care and will carry us into the future.
My favourite thing is that we stuck with principles. The first principle is no cuts to services. The second principle, no cuts to staff. And working from those two principles, you could make a clear way forward. And so in the end, we have a consistent budget with consistent principles that will lead us forward. And it's actually much more efficient to work off principles, and we've done a great job. So hats off to all of Noosa.
Finally, I'd like to take this opportunity to thank my fellow councillors, the CEO of Noosa Council, Brett DeChastel, the Director of Corporate Services, Michael Shave, and all the team here at Council. This has really been a team effort in very trying times. This is a grassroots, back to community budget. This is a budget for you. Good afternoon.